Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel Shraddha's Physics. Today we will discuss about the relation between dielectric constant and electric susceptibility. So let us start our topic, that is the relation between the susceptibility and the dielectric constant. So let us consider a parallel plate capacitor. Just try to write with me. Parallel plate capacitor. Capacitor filled with vacuum or air. Vacuum or air as the medium. Okay. Now suppose here, if I'll draw, this is my parallel plate capacitor, and here there is no medium, or we can say that this is vacuum inside it, or it may be the air is the medium in between this plate of the capacitor. So let us consider the Q is the charge on the capacitor. So let me write it. So let Q equal to the Q, this is equal to the charge on the capacitor. Q is the charge on the capacitor, and sigma is the surface charge density. This is the surface charge density of the capacitor, surface charge density, or we can say that of the plate of the capacitor, okay. Capacitor means its plates. Okay, that is, when this plate is charged, that is the charges that lies on the surface of this capacitor. These are the, suppose plus Q charges are here, and these are some minus Q charges are present at this end or at this plate, or we can say that this plate is charged. Now there will be electric field. That is suppose E naught. This is suppose the electric field E naught can be found between this plate of the capacitor, or here we can write that here E naught. This E naught is the electric field. This is the electric field between the plate of the capacitor. This is the electric field between the plate of the capacitor. So from the previous lecture, we have already discussed that this E naught is nothing but the charge density, that is the surface charge density sigma, divided by epsilon naught. We have already discussed about this E naught. These are the free charges. This is because of this electric field is E naught, and the charges present on the surface of the capacitor plate, these are the free charges, and this E naught equal to sigma by epsilon naught. Now when a dielectric is inserted, then what will happen? The dielectric will get polarized first. Dielectric get polarized. So the electric field develop, get polarized, and there will be, so there will be an induced electric field, and there will be an induced electric field. So the net electric field inside this capacitor, so let me write, the net electric field, net electric field inside the capacitor, this is because of the bound charge. Okay, this is because of the bound charge. The net electric field inside the capacitor is, so let me explain it in this diagram. So here you can see that in this capacitor, if I will introduce a dielectric slab, so suppose this is my dielectric slab. When I introduce this dielectric slab, then this dielectric slab get polarized and the charges will lie at this part, only at this part inside this dielectric slab. So you can say that this dielectric get polarized and there will be an electric field, that is the induced electric field will develop in this direction, that is suppose EP. This is my electric field direction. So here these charges are called the bound charges, and because of these charges, so the net electric field inside this dielectric, this will be E naught minus EP. So this is the net electric field, or this can be written as this is equal to E. So here we can write the net electric field inside the capacitor is E equal to E naught minus EP. Okay, this is my net electric field. And also we know that this induced electric field, this EP, this is nothing but sigma P divided by epsilon naught. This induced electric field, this is nothing but sigma P by epsilon naught. What is this sigma P? This sigma P is nothing but the surface charge density. This is the surface charge density. Surface charge density due to the bound charge, or you can say that because of induced charge. Surface charge density due to induced charges. Okay, due to induced charges. Okay. Now if I will put the value of EP, that is sigma P by epsilon naught, then this will be equal to E naught minus, in place of EP I will write sigma P divided by epsilon naught. But we know the polarization vector, we have proved that this polarization P vector, this is equal to surface charge density due to the bound charges, that is sigma P. So if I will put, this will be equal to E naught minus this polarization vector capital P divided by epsilon naught. If you have not seen this part, P equal to sigma P, then you can see this proof in the previous lecture or the previous part of this video. Now what will happen? E equal to, up to this much we have already calculated, E equal to E naught minus the polarization vector P divided by epsilon. Now if I will divide this electric field, that is the net electric field E, in the both side, then what will happen? So dividing E on both sides, this E by E, this is 1, that is equal to E naught divided by E, actually I am writing the E only the magnitude part, minus P divided by epsilon naught into E. Okay, and we know the dielectric constant K equal to E naught divided by E. I have already discussed this. And this electric susceptibility chi e, chi substitute e this is equal to the polarization vector P divided by epsilon naught into E. These things are already been discussed. Okay, now if I'll put these things in this expression, that is suppose the equation 1, then this will be 1 equal to this E naught by E is nothing but K minus this P by epsilon naught E is chi. So this will be 1 equal to K minus chi, or this can be written as, so this implies K will be equal to, that is the dielectric constant equal to 1 plus the electric susceptibility, that is chi E. This is the very important relation, that is the dielectric constant, how the dielectric constant related to the electric susceptibility. So K equal to 1 plus chi E. This electrical behavior of the material completely specified by either the permittivity epsilon or the susceptibility chi. Okay. Now if I write a relation, that is suppose epsilon equal to, you know, this is K into epsilon naught, K is the dielectric constant and epsilon is the permittivity, and epsilon naught is the permittivity in free space. Then we can write K will be equal to this K, that is equal to epsilon divided by epsilon naught. Okay, and again this epsilon is nothing but epsilon naught plus chi. From where this relation comes? So if I express it here, you know, the polarization vector P is directly proportional to the electric field vector E. That implies you can write this polarization P, this is equal to chi into E. Chi is the proportionality constant, or this is the susceptibility of the material. And also, you know, the displacement vector D equal to epsilon into E. But in the free space, we can write this displacement vector D, that is equal to epsilon naught into E plus the polarization P. Okay. Now, if I put this expression, this is suppose equation 2, equation 3, and this is suppose equation 4. Now, if I put equation 2 and equation 3 in equation 4, so this will be, that implies in place of D, I will put epsilon into E, that is equal to epsilon naught into E plus P value is chi into E. Now we can cancel this electric field in the both side, then that implies epsilon will be equal to epsilon naught plus chi. So from this relation, epsilon equal to epsilon naught plus chi, here I have substituted this epsilon equal to epsilon naught plus chi divided by this epsilon naught. Okay. Now that implies if I divide this K will be equal, if I divide epsilon naught with epsilon naught, this will be 1 plus chi divided by epsilon naught. So this is the behavior in case of free space. If I put this relation, this is for your free space, then the relation will be like K equal to 1 plus chi by epsilon naught. So let me solve one question. So don't get first let me show you one thing. Here just we have calculated K equal to 1 plus chi. Here I have proved that K equal to 1 plus chi by epsilon naught. If you will put this P equal to, here P equal to chi into E. This chi is nothing but P by E, polarization vector divided by this electric field. So this K equal to, if I will put this 1 plus P divided by epsilon naught E. So this is nothing but chi E. Okay. So this both relations are equal, that is K equal to here 1 plus chi. This also true. Okay. That is from this equation 2, this chi equal to P by E. So if I will put this chi value here, then this will be K equal to 1 plus P by epsilon naught E. So this will be K equal to 1 plus chi, since chi E equal to P by epsilon naught E. Now let me solve one problem for you. The first question is, the electric susceptibility of a material
is 35.4 into 10 power minus 12 coulomb square per newton meter square. So what is the value of, the question is, what is the value of the dielectric constant, the value of dielectric constant, and the second one is we have to calculate the permittivity of the material, the permittivity of the material. Okay, so let me first calculate the dielectric constant. So here the susceptibility is given, so you have to calculate first the dielectric constant. So from the unit, here the electric susceptibility unit is given, coulomb square per newton meter square. So simply here chi is given, so here I will write chi is given, that is 35.4 into 10 power minus 12 coulomb square per newton meter square. So here epsilon naught, you know the value of epsilon naught is 8.85 into 10 raised power minus 12 coulomb square per newton meter square. Why I am writing this? Because which relation you will use? K equal to 1 plus chi or 1 plus chi by epsilon naught? Since here you can see simply this chi unit is coulomb square per newton meter square, but you know the dielectric constant has no unit. Okay, it has no unit. This is your chi. Okay, this K has no unit. So this susceptibility, if it will get divided with this epsilon naught, then this coulomb square per newton meter square and this coulomb square per newton meter square, they will get cancelled. So finally, they will have no unit. That's why this is simply K equal to 1 plus chi by epsilon naught. So this is just a trick so that you can guess. Now, this K will be equal to, this K part, let me write. This is equal to 1 plus, the chi value is 35.4 into 10 power minus 12 divided by 8.85 into 10 power minus 12. So this 10 power minus 12 get cancelled. This is 35.4 divided by 8.85. Okay, sorry for the disturbance. So this is simply just 4 times of this. You can see. Now this will be equal to 1 plus, this is just near about 1 plus 4. That implies K will be equal to 5. This is the value of the dielectric constant. Now, what do we have to calculate? Dielectric constant, here we have calculated, the value is 5. Dielectric constant is 5. Now we have to calculate the permittivity of the material. Now, the second bit is the permittivity. You know the permittivity epsilon is equal to K into epsilon naught, then this will be equal to 5 into 8.85 into 10 power minus 12. So this will be 5 times 25, so it is 2. 5 times 40, 40 plus 2, 42. So 2 here, so 5 times 40 plus 4, that is 44. So this is simply 44.25 into 10 power minus 12. So the unit of epsilon is coulomb square per newton meter square. Okay. So in this way, you can solve this question. Okay. Here the susceptibility is given. So the question will be like the, you have to calculate the dielectric constant or the permittivity of the material. So this is all for today. If you have any doubt, can ask me in the comment section. Just try to solve some more problems on this part specially. If you like the video, hit the like button, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.